Oh, Timmy, you're even more licky than last time.
What a simply wonderful start to the holes. A hilltop picnic and just the five of us.
Here, here.
Gosh, I must have the appetite of a pig. I've eaten 13 rounds of ham and turkey sandwiches, and I'm still hungry.
I expect you've got worms.
Yes, or malnutrition.
Steady on, you two.
Gosh, isn't it sad to think there are people in this world who are starving?
Yes, I suppose it is.
Still, if they didn't breed like rabbits, there'd be more to go round.
Yes, that's true.
Mind you, half of them die in childbirth, so it must all even up in the end, I suppose.
Oh, dear. I do wish there was something we could do to help.
Poor old Anne. Just like a girl to get het up about world problems on a lovely day like this.
Well, it doesn't worry me.
I agree with Dick. Africa's miles away from here. Come on, let's enjoy the holes. I think it's the order of the day.
We've only got seven up.
I beg your pardon?
We don't sell ginger beer.
Oh, well, in that case, five of your delicious homemade ice creams will do splendidly.
We got lollies.
Lollies?
Strawberry flavour or vanilla flavour?
Which do you recommend?
Don't know.
Well, in that case, we'll have two of each. Thank you. What a queer girl.
I think she looks cheap.
Yes, and mentally retarded.
I wouldn't be surprised if she comes from a broken home. What do you say, Dick?
Yes. Or maybe she's adopted. That's even more likely.
Hmm. Delicious. I expect you must love it here, living in such an idyllic spot.
You must be joking.
Why is that?
It's the most boring place on earth, if you really want to know.
Well, if I lived here, I wouldn't be bored. I think you're jolly lucky.
Yes, I can't wait to go exploring for seashells and wildflowers. Not that I'll pick too many, of course.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Anne.
Here is an important newsflash. Uncle Quentin, the well-known scientist and homosexual, has escaped from prison. So far, the police have found no trace of him, although they're known to be carrying out inquiries at well-known public schools in the area.
Did you hear that? Uncle Quentin has escaped!
Oh, it's horrible to think of Uncle Quentin on the loose again. I do hope they catch him soon.
Don't worry, Anne. I'm sure the police are doing everything they can. And I wouldn't mind betting they'll soon have him locked up in a special prison.
Yes, just like Rudolf Hess.
Poor bastard.
Jenny, it's time to come and feed your illegitimate baby.
Sorry about that, girl. She's not mine. She's...
Oh, we quite understand.
Did you want anything else, young gent?
Yes. As a matter of fact, we're staying with a Mrs. French at Hot Turkey Farm. Perhaps you know her.
Oh, yes, a dear old soul. Leastways, she was, until the menopause hit her and she grassed us all to the filth. Still, can't blame the poor old soul, I suppose. What with that wicked son of hers and his comings and goings in that strange love island just across the water. It'd be enough to send anyone out to lunch. Still, no doubt they'll be right up your apples and pears. I'll be bound.
Gosh, that sounds exciting.
I agree. Well, we'd better be going now. Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye. Bye.
turkey farm that's just over this hill.
Wizard, I'm starving.
Gosh, look over there.
That must be Love Island.
So it is.
Why on earth do you think she called it strange? I think it sounds rather romantic.
Yes, well, you would, wouldn't you? Love Island? I think it sounds queer.
Steady on, you two. Look out! Clumsy idiot. He could have killed us all driving in that irresponsible manner.
Ugh, with a vulgar car, too.
Yes, I agree. Do you think they're Americans, Jew? Yes, that old Catholics. Come on, let's find the farmhouse.
Dairy farm this is.
Must be that son's fault.
Yes, I must say, he did sound like a rather nasty piece of work.
You better do what I'm telling you, Ma, or it's going to be the worst for you.
Help! Oh, you were a good son once. Now you've fallen into bad company.
Never mind all that. All I care about is selling the family farm and taking all the money.
Shall we knock?
Not yet.
You were such a lovely baby.
Shut up! You set up everything like I'm saying. Or else, I'm going off gambling now, so don't wait up for me. Oh, God, what's all this?
Good afternoon. I hope we're not disturbing you, but we're the Famous Five, and we're here to stay for a fortnight's farm holiday.
Well, I'm very sorry, Mr. Famous Five, but I'm afraid your lovely farm holiday has just been cancelled. So piss off and don't interfere in my secret arrangements.
Oh, don't mind him, dear. He's drunk, that's all. Do come in. I expect you'd like to start stuffing yourselves right away, don't you?
Rather!
Well, your Aunt Fanny did write to me about your excessive gluttony, so I've prepared you a meal that would kill an elephant.
Hurrah!
That was grand.
I must say, you kids can certainly pack it away.
Well, I think as soon as the girls have done the washing up, we should all turn in.
Yes, I feel whacked.
Well, now, I've put you girls in the back room. And I thought you boys wouldn't mind sharing with a nice, rich American boy.
American?
Yes. Or you could both shack up with me.
I'm game.
Well, I think with all due respect, Mrs. French, Dick and I would rather sleep in a ditch.
What's all this about an American?
Oh, he's staying here with his father and paying me through the nose, I can tell you. Oh, that must be them now.
Hiya, folks. Me and Willie are over here to buy up anything old we can get our uncultured hands on. How do you do?
Gee, shucks, Pop. I'm hungry. Tell that woman to fix my dinner now. And none of that shepherd's crumble stuff. Yuck!
Tell yourself, Willie. I'm too busy thinking about buying up all this heritage crap and shipping it back to America. For a profit. $300.
Howdy, folks. Say, how's about you and me being buddies? We could have a real...